Hi, so this is to show you how to replace any of the internal parts of the Reef LED. First thing you want to do, make sure that we are not connected to the DC power supply, and it's best to work on some kind of soft mat so that you don't do any damage to the unit. Firstly, remove the top cover by clicking it in the corners and place that on one side. Then we're going to remove the four screws. First two screws we're going to remove completely. Second two screws, just release the threads, but don't take them out. And then we're just going to tap it lightly to release the front cover. Taking a flathead screwdriver, just gently prise it open. And then just put this on one side. Here we have the electronic boards, and here we have the LED array. First thing we're going to do is to replace the electronic boards. First thing, remove the connector of the fan and leave it on one side. The next thing we need to do is to disconnect the DC cable, and this is done with a flathead screwdriver, pressing down first of all on the black wire and pulling it out, and again on the white one, and that's now released. We have four screws on top that need to be removed. Just put them all nicely on one side, and then gently remove the board. There is a connector there, and you need to pull it up vertically so as not to damage the pins on the connector. The DC cable now comes out. It's best to use a small socket wrench here, but if you haven't got one, a pair of pliers will do. Just gently release the four spacers by like that, and then they should completely unscrew very easily. One, two, three, four. In order to remove the bottom board, we just have to prise it up a little bit. It's not glued, but it might have got a little bit stuck. And now we just slide it back and take it out. That's the disassembly. Take care not to touch the top surface of the LED array, because this will possibly cause some damage to it later on. Let's put all that on one side for a minute. This is the kit you'll get if you have to replace the electronic boards. And when you open it up, you will find a bag with a complete set of the screws, the spacers, and the battery. You will find a bubble pack with the boards on the inside. You'll find the top and bottom board and a replacement cable tie if you need it for the DC cable. I'm going to put all of this on one side and return the original ones, because there's nothing wrong with them. The one point I wish to make is that in the bag of parts you will find a label with the serial number, which relates to the serial number of the boards. And when you've done the replacement, you should then take that label and put it onto the back of the unit. So, let's reassemble the boards. We do exactly the same job that we did, but in the opposite order. We assemble the bottom board by sliding it gently onto the connector pins of the LED array. and make sure that the holes are aligned. We can use the original screws and spacers. First of all, tighten them all by hand. As I said, if you've got a socket wrench, then that'll work very nicely. And when they are hand tight, just take your pair of pliers and make sure they are properly seated. When we've done that, we need to put our cable back in its position, and we can reuse this just to keep the cables on one side. And then we put our top board back. Just make sure again the pins are aligned with the connector. Push down gently, align our holes, return our screws. When we've done that, we need to reconnect the DC cable. The white wire is the plus wire, and that just goes push in there. And the black wire is the negative or the ground wire, and that just pushes in there. Pull back on both just to make sure that they are done. And now reconnect the fan connector, and we are ready to continue. To continue, place the cover back on top, and we can return the screws. Top cover just clips back into place, and there we are ready to go back into operation.